This is a KCCI editorial.
Recently, KCCI reporter Laura Terrell shared a heartbreaking story with us. Laura interviewed a brave mother and father who shared the pain of losing their daughter to domestic violence. Their daughter was beaten to death by her boyfriend this past January.
And I went into the bedroom and I found her on the floor. I knew exactly who did it, absolutely. She had asked him to leave the house. She was breaking up with him.
Before her suspected killer could be apprehended, he committed suicide. News organizations, including KCCI, reported on this horrific story. Not long after the reporting, the Allens noticed a growing memorial outside their daughter's home. Survivors of domestic violence started leaving flowers and sharing their stories. The Allens knew their daughter's abuse and murder was impacting many other victims of domestic violence. It's what led them to share their story with Laura. Sadly, the Allen family is not alone. The prevalence of domestic violence has grown. Since 1995, reports show that 375 Iowans have died by domestic murder. More than a third of those were killed by a dating partner. Iowa law treats dating violence like regular assault when there is no cohabitation or a shared child. It's a loophole that allows violence to go unchecked until it's too late. If you haven't seen the story, we encourage you to watch it at kcci.com. If you're in an abusive situation, help is available. You can text Iowa Help at 20121. You can also call 1-800-770-1650. When domestic abuse is ongoing, the most dangerous place to be is at home. We thank the Allens for sharing their story with us. Furthermore, we encourage Iowa lawmakers to fix our domestic violence laws. Domestic abuse can hide in plain sight. We must make sure we have the toughest laws possible to give those who suffer the best chance to get the help and protection they need before it's too late.
KCCI welcomes responsible replies to this editorial.